The stories that Steve told in his speech really inspired me.
And it challenged me to rethink where I am and where I'm going.
I laughed so hard at some of those funny stories.
Stephen, the third son of President Gerald Ford.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Every boy's dream to grow up to be like his father, huh?
Hopefully my stories will make you a little more familiar with the White House and some of the things that happened there.
Mr. President, if you could just call back on the other line, Betty could get on.
And I took my 10 Secret Service agents out west. These are my agents.
About 10 years ago, my life came crashing down because I became an alcoholic.
The value and the success for them that I see through my eyes is how they led our family.
Character is what you do when no one's looking.
You can't have a life without writing a script for your life or what you want. And I want you to be the director of your life. I don't want you to be the prop man. I want you to write a great script for your life, to be the hero in that script.
I ask you, are you leaving powerful stories for your children?
Are you stuck? Is there a time in your life you've been stuck with your family, your career, your friends, things that seem to be passing you by? Because that happens to me. And I wonder sometimes, do I have a big enough vision for change, to allow change to happen in my life? Let me tell you a quick story here. Something that happened to the Ford family. About 8 months ago, my dad was back at the Republican National Convention in Philadelphia. And he had a stroke. He went in the hospital, had to have surgery. The whole Ford family, we all flew back to be with him. And the next morning when he was going through surgery, we sat there in the recovery room waiting for him. And this doctor walked up to me, one of his doctors. With this heavy European accent, he walked up and goes, I want to tell you something, how much this world is changing. And I listened, and he says, when I first saw your father, he was my enemy. I was a 14-year-old boy, and I saw your father get off the plane to meet my president in Russia, President Brezhnev, and I saw your father as my enemy. And here I am, 27 years later. One of the doctors that's helping save your father's life. Now that's change. And I ask you, I challenge me, do we have a big enough vision in our life to allow that kind of change to happen with our families, our friends, and our career?
Welcome, I'm Steve Ford. Some of you probably recognize me from when my father was president of the United States and took over the reins of this country at a very tough time in American history. Others of you probably remember me from some of the hundreds of TV shows and over 30 films I've worked on in Hollywood as an actor over the last 20 years, such as these.
We are going in with first wave.
He's more bugs for us to kill.
You smash the entire area. You kill anything that has more than two legs. You get me?
We get you, sir.
I told my dad that I didn't want him to go.
Daddy, don't go.
Nothing would give me more pride than to represent my country. But what can I say to this?
Daddy! Daddy!
My little girl!
I thought you were gone, Daddy. I thought you were gone forever.
Oh, baby. I would never leave you forever.
We've handled these types of situations before.
You still haven't answered my question.
We told you there'd be risks.
You also told me I would be under complete protection the entire time.
This is U.S. Marshal John Kruger with the Witness Protection Program. He'll be handling your personal security.
You expect me to what, give up my whole life over this?
Just until the trial. And then you're going to be completely out of danger.
This is our war. Not yours. That's genocide.
How'd he strike you?
Urbane, sophisticated.
Cool. Yeah, he's a good catch. It'll take some time, but that deed will feel the loss.
I'm not sure time is something we got in great supply.
This isn't Iraq, you know. It's more complicated than that.
Boss, most of Washington might disagree. I'm just saying they've been calling for these dang situation reports every morning this week.
Well, tell them the situation is fragile.
He set up a casualty collection point. I don't think they're going to be able to move. Sergeant Sanderson and a small Delta team are moving from Steele's position to the crash site as we speak.
Good night.
Between the 10th Mountain and the UN, we've got enough personnel, okay?
Danny, you guys do not have to go back out again.
Joe, I thought it was you. I thought it was you, Harry Burns.
Harry, how you doing?
Good. How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
That's great. Yeah. I was just walking by and I thought it was you, and there it is. It's you.
Yeah, it was. Oh, Harry, this is Sally Albright, Harry Burns. Harry and I, we lived in the same building.
Well, listen, I got a plane to catch. It was really good to see you, Joe.
You too, Harry.
Thank God he couldn't place me. I drove from college to New York with him 5 years ago, and it was the longest night of my life.
What happened?
He made a pass at me, and when I said no, he was going with a girlfriend of mine. Oh, God, I can't remember her name.
So what happened?
When
he made a pass at you, you said no.
Oh. I said we could just be friends. And this part I remember. He said that men and women could never really be friends. Do you think that's true?
No.
Do you have any women friends, just friends?
No.
But today I come to you as a keynote speaker. My unique talk is from the perspective of growing up in America's most famous home, 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, the White House. It's the lessons I've learned in life, the inspiring stories of family and country and overcoming adversity. It's the insider's look at the White House, the funny little stories, the anecdotes, the stories you never heard before. And you actually get to see the real photos and slides of the events as I tell the story. My talk is going to make you laugh. It's going to make you cry. It's going to motivate you. It's going to make you rethink your life, to have a vision for your family and yourself. Most of all, you're going to walk away feeling good about yourself, your family's potential in this great country.